you often treat the face in a very radical way. And we're standing actually under memories of Rembrandt. And it no longer feels like simply the face of an individual subject. It almost feels more like an interior landscape.
You know, I read that story, The Myth of Sisyphus of Camus, you know, and the idea of this guy sort of rolling a rock up to the top of a hill, and that hill became like the chin, and the rock became the nose, and the features were sort of filled in around it in a strange way, and the feet of having it constantly, you know, constantly turning back into something. And it's the idea of the landscape as a face, and creating that kind of a, where you, through the sort of topography of the face, you can convey the inner emotions and the inner states of mind of the subject for what you're painting. So then it really is like, that's a good example, in my opinion, of say what a mental state painting is all about. That may not be the way somebody looks, but that's the way they think. That's the way they feel. If you went into the mind of that person, that's what it would look like.